Okay, you read that right. This video is all about North American devs fleeing to Japan. Bit of an extreme title there, but I get it. But I'll explain to you, I've made this channel nearly 2 years ago, and I do talk to a lot of North Americans, meaning Canadians and Americans, United States of America, and they all try to ask me, how can I work in Japan? And I think, I'm not going to explain how to do it. This video is explaining why they want to immigrate to Japan, why they want to work in Japan, why they want to live in Japan. And these are some of the reasons why they're pushing for it. In this video, I'll be explaining you the top five reasons North American engineers want to come to Japan. And some of it is shocking, some of it not so shocking. And maybe for most of you, you will be watching this going, yeah, that's me too. So anyway, let's just get through this. So a big issue is happening in some of these cities in America, or maybe Canada, maybe more so in America, is that they told me crime's on the rise. So even if they can get a nice incomes in some areas, they might have to live in a cheap area, or, you know, even in the nice areas, there's a bit of crime. There's homelessness, so you can call this some type of a civil unrest of some sort. Not like an apocalyptic post, not this type of world, but just in general, they don't feel safe walking outside or even just going to the supermarket during the day. You know, it depends on the area. I know. But I'm just telling you, I'm just parlaying, is it the word? I'm just telling you what they told me, okay? Number one is crime. Okay, another one that you can see recently is maybe there's a tech bubble in America, North America, in the North Americas. And when you had the tech bubble, you probably had a lot of students applying for, you know, computer science degrees. They spent a lot of money, sometimes the parents' life savings. So there's a lot of competition in North America. And when you have a bubble that pops, you suddenly have a lot of unemployed, highly skilled workers. And that's something that I was told that 3 years ago they would be able to make. Let's say one guy said in my community, a Canadian, I think he's in Canada, non-Canadian, but in Canada, he was able to make, I think it was $70 an hour, I forgot. And then now it's the same type of work is coming up for like under $50 an hour or something. There are some discussions I've had like this. Other people told me, Canadian friends who a few years in the industry told me that they lost their job and they can't find another one. And I've checked the GitHub there. I don't see why they shouldn't have a job. Maybe there are other reasons to this. I don't know. But these are common issues which I've heard. The job security is you don't know when you're gonna get fired, and you don't know if you're gonna get hired. And of course, if you're 5 years experience or so or more, and you have decent enough skills, it probably won't affect you. But you can also see some people around with a lot of skill and experience that are not being able to find even freelance work. So I don't know how bad it is. And this is not a channel to bring up charts. I'm just telling you what they told me. And then in Japan, I released a video a few weeks ago about never getting fired in Japan. And of course, it was based on my experience, and apparently people do. But still, there are a lot of job opportunities in Japan. And when foreigners see some of my videos and how much of a soy dev I am, and how I'm able to get projects, they think, is this an easier route? Or not say easier route, the route of least resistance. I don't know if I can get an American project, to be honest. The competition is so high. They leet everyone from head to toe. They leet your body, and they crush your soul. And then if you get into the company, they might just fire you because you liked the wrong post. You know, you can go on. I'll save that for the fifth reason. But job security is something that is extremely serious. You know, you've got rent to pay. You've got kids to feed. You've got a dog somewhere. You got a dog somewhere, and that's serious stuff, guys. Okay, the next one is a bit of a shocker, or maybe not a shocker. I don't know. You tell me. Is that people want to find the waifu? The waifu a partner, and it seems that it's getting quite tricky for some people in North America. So let's say you watch some content. I'm not going to say what type. I'm not saying. Or maybe you are more into a traditional lifestyle. That is something that some people want. They want a traditional family. They want a traditional lifestyle. And when you see a country like Japan, who more or less does keep those traditions. Oh, yeah, but my friend in Tokyo, shush. Oh, yeah, but, you know, things are changing. Shush. Of course, it's changing. But in general, okay? Oh, yeah, but shh. It is like that here, and people find that as something that they want to live a life like that, and that might mean changing the language you speak with your spouse or your girlfriend. I'm not gonna say anything negative about different cultures and stuff, but I think they are telling me, they just don't feel hopeful to find a partner in North America. And that's a real thing, and I'm not here to do some type of manosphere content. No, this is real. You cannot continue your DNA, your genetics, your mother's waiting for grandkids and so forth. This is a serious topic, so I don't want to go too deep into it, but a lot of people can't get the waifu in North America. This is a big one, and it's in Auckland and Sydney. Of course, New Zealand, Australia is having a very similar issue, and that's the cost of living, and mostly the cost of rent and mortgage. People are getting these great tech jobs in these massive, Silicon Valley, but they're realizing that a large percentage of it would have to go to a mortgage or renting a real small place. Well, I don't think your space is going to get any larger in Tokyo or in Japan, but they see things like Akia, free housing within 2 hours of Japan. These North Americans are also seeing the cost of food. They are seeing transportation is being paid by the company. Transport goes everywhere. It's safe. Oh, back to the security thing. So when you see these, and even if you adjust your income to Japanese yen, the average engineer, you might get more out of life for that full-time job. This is a serious issue in Auckland as well. I'm thinking of going back sometime next year for a couple of months, and rent is quite high. And there are investors, there are speculators, foreign investors, and even your young families are just trying to get onto the property ladder, but it's taking them like at least 5 years or so of saving up for a deposit. And 5 years deposit, that's a lot of money. Instead of saving 5 years deposit a few hundred K in like Auckland or Sydney, 200 K can get you a really decent house within 1 hour. One hour and a bit out of Tokyo, paid off. So you can pay off your house in 5 years. This is a great opportunity for foreigners who wanna. So early retirement is a lot more attainable maybe in countries like Japan. The last topic is quite sensitive, so I'll be careful how I phrase it. And I've been in the, let's say, crossfires of this, so I gotta be careful how I use my words. But there is a cultural, but these are, we work in IT, right? And in IT, especially in the Western countries, there's a certain culture that's being pushed lately. And it's not just one or two things, it's a multitude of ideas that you may not agree with and you cannot disagree with, or else you will be, some people get fired for this stuff. Some people get demoted. You know, this kind of stuff is, it's not a joke, and I don't like, I personally, I really dislike this type of culture that we're seeing, and it is coming into, it is making its way through New Zealand. It's probably well in Australia already. It's already in New Zealand, but when you have that type of culture, people might leave. I'm not talking to some guy who just learned how to code yesterday. This guy has been coding for 10 years and he wants to get out. And so when you hear things like this, you can't just put everyone into a category of or they are whatever ists, you know, the isms and the ists. These are people from all different types of races, religions, and cultures, and they're telling me very similar things. I just want to do. One guy told me this: I just want to work on really cool stuff, but my company's pushing this thing to me, and that's terrible. You are stopping bright, smart, creative people from feeling comfortable to just do their job. So I'm getting this so much lately, and they ask me, what is it like working in Japanese companies? So I'm not going to explain the culture in Japan, but I'm just explaining the reasons why Americans or North Americans are leaving the IT companies in America. So you tell me, is this, if you're from North America or you're working in North America, what are some things, are these some of the things that you have an issue with and that's why you want to move? Or if you already moved here, were these some of the issues that you had? Because I'd love to hear. Am I wrong about this? I'm not wrong. I'm just telling you what people told me. And that's, I've interviewed so many different people. So you tell me. From my personal experience, I'm from New Zealand. And being here for quite a while, I did think it sometimes wasn't worth it. Now I have videos about was it worth it to live here and work. And I think in the past 4 years or so, I really do believe it was worth it. It was. I dodged a lot of things that would have happened to me in New Zealand, especially in 2020. You know what happened then? Yeah, we know what happened then. And I was so grateful to be. Japan's been so good to me. I really appreciate that from 2020, the way that the country took it, like looked after everyone, the way that people in general respected. To not, you know, I mean, not everyone, but you weren't ostracized. You weren't. There is less of that type of culture, which is great. And then, of course, I'll quickly go over these five topics and what I think about it. Crime, yeah, I've never felt unsafe in Japan, unless it's something to do with, you know, Westerners or something, or, you know, I'm not gonna go into that. Job security. As you've seen my videos, even a person like me can, okay, I say even a person, I do try my best, but there are definitely a lot of opportunities around. And you don't just have to be an engineer, there are a lot of opportunities. The waifu, I'm not complaining. And I'm not, it's not a boast. I'm not, there's not a manosphere, no. Traditionalism is still quite live, well working. And of course, doesn't mean. I'm not guaranteeing you when you fly off the plane, you're gonna, you know, put a ring on someone and no, that's not, I'm not guaranteeing that, but I don't know how it would work in New Zealand. I seriously don't know. And I'm not, I'm not a, I know I'm not a 10 out of 10, okay, I calm down, I know. Oh, I'm not a 5, oh, maybe I'm a 5, I don't know. But yeah, that will depend on you, but yeah, enough waifu stuff. I don't want to get in trouble. This is not the Manosphere channel, but I'm doing well, thank you. Cost of living, yes, this is great. Just buy me some crackers. I got me some wine or cheap stuff. Just enjoy it, no worries. If I want to go out, have a nice meal, it's not so expensive. I can only compare back in Auckland City. You might pay $30 for something and it might taste like cardboard. You pay $30 for something in Tokyo, you're gonna have a good meal. You're gonna have a great meal. So, cost of living, my rent is relatively cheap compared to what I would be. I would never get this in Auckland City. This guy there sleeping, little buddy there. So, cost of living, can't complain, can't complain. But also, remember, I make. A little, if you watch my previous video, I make a little bit more, but even if I didn't make that much, if I made half of what I'm making now, I could still live quite a decent lifestyle. Not a rich one, but you know, I can do things like buy expensive Pokemon things and hold them and sell them 5 times to New Zealanders in 5 years or something like that. So we're talking about the last one, the culture. Yeah, look, if you follow my stuff and you can see I had a few issues with Westerners in Tokyo, and that's something that is it is alarming. It is something that you have to be careful about. You don't, I'm not worried about Japanese culture. I respect it, and I work with Japanese for 12 years now, and I just know, I just keep to myself, and they respect me. I have no issue. I have no complaint about working with Japanese. Okay, this is not a, I don't go to other countries and complain about how it should be. And I think a lot of Westerners do that in Japan. Of course, like a Vietnamese, Chinese, and Koreans will all do it, but the echo chamber, the loud minority, is it's slowly building up in Tokyo in the last few years. So it's something to be wary of. And in that case, you just you probably won't see them every day to day, or you just don't work in Tokyo and you're fine. But it's nothing serious, to be honest. In general, the work culture, you may disagree with some things, which is gonna, you will disagree. And just like any engineer who goes to New Zealand will disagree. Cultures are different, and but I must say, I prefer many things here. Doesn't mean I don't like what, I'm of a Catholic heritage, right? So a Western civilization. So yeah, of course I'm gonna favor, the way I was raised in Western world. But for now, in the last few years, it's good. It's good. Yep, no problem. You tell me, what do you think about all the stuff? I'm gonna enjoy some cheese and wine, some very cheap cheese and wine. This is cheap. This is cheap wine. I think cheap wine is cheap everywhere. It's like 500 yen for Chilean wine from 7-Eleven, and this is just a 200, under 200 yen for some kitty cheese and crackers. Hey, life's great. Dog's sleeping. I'm checking out some gaming stuff. I'm counting the my weeb investments. So yeah, can't complain.